Hello everybody and welcome to a train simulator video. Today we shall be driving a class 350 Desiro Electric Multiple Unit from just outside of Hanslope Junction on the West Coast Main Line to London Euston. So the first thing we need to do is turn off the pause menu. And we are currently sat outside a red signal, so we need to press Shift and W to insert the master key. Press W again to put the train into gear. Acknowledge the automatic warning system. And then we need to press I for the instrument lights, H a couple of times for the daytime headlights, and then we need to press F8 for London Euston on the destination blind, and then we can press Control 1 to agree to the terms of the train management system, and then we need to press Control D for the vigilance device. So the scenario we are playing does come with a route by default. However, I have edited a couple of things about it. First of all, you'll notice there is no score. That's because I've cloned it and made the clone a standard scenario, so we don't need to worry about any scoring. I've also changed the player train to the Armstrong Powerhouse Class 350, which is based off the Class 450, which comes with the Portsmouth Direct Line, London-Waterloo to Portsmouth route. So you will need that piece of rolling stock in order for this Class 350 pack to function as intended. So with a single aspect change, we can now depart. And we are subject to a severe 30 miles per hour temporary speed restriction. Which is just round this bend. Can now accelerate up to the line speed of 100 miles per hour. And the West Coast Main Line has now appeared on our right hand side. Now we're going to have to slow down to 70 miles per hour as we are switching over to the fast lines. We can now accelerate up to 110 miles per hour, which is the maximum speed of the Class 350/1, which is the subvariant of multiple unit that we have. And we've got about 3 miles to go to our first station stop at Wolverton. We're going to have to prepare to stop at Wolverton now, so just going to start applying the brakes. And here at Wolverton. This is the station entrance at Wolverton, which looks rather nice. Thought I'd choose this scenario because it gives us a chance to have a quick look at the some of the intermediate stopping points, which we didn't get to look at in the first video of West Coast Main Line South, which was on the Pendolino. So departing Wolverton, we've got about 2 miles to go to our next station stop at Milton Keynes. Now I'm going to have to get ready to stop at Milton Keynes, so I'll start braking. Okay, so here we are at Milton Keynes. And this is the main station entrance. It's just a big glass building. Our next station stop is at Bletchley, which is about 3 miles away. And just before Bletchley, we will be switching back over to the slow lines. We're now going to get ready to slow down to 30. We can now accelerate back up to line speed. Wasn't quite sure what that AWS magnet was for. I think it was for that signal, but it was displaying a clear aspect, so I don't know why the alarm sounded there. Speed limit is about to drop down to 75 miles per hour. And we're going to get ready to stop at Bletchley. So we're going to start braking. And here we are at Bletchley. See station entrance. So it's okay. So we've now got about 18 miles to go to our next station stop at Berkhamsted. So we'll be running through non-stop through Leighton Buzzard, Cheddington and Tring. Line speed is now 100 miles per hour, which is the maximum speed for the slow lines. Just shut the power off now as we've reached line speed. Just past a freight liner class 66. That should be the Power Hall 66, but for some reason it wasn't showing up correctly in the scenario. I was getting the floating couplings, and I believe that's as a result of me not reinstalling the Armstrong Powerhouse EP for it in order for it to copy over the GEO files. So I've just had to, I haven't had a chance to re-download the 66 pack yet. So what I did is I swapped out for an existing 66 on my install. So it's just in the regular Freightliner colours. Got to slow down to 90 miles per hour now. Those of you who've also probably played this scenario previously will know that by default it is set in the fog. However, I have also changed the weather to a pattern from the Armstrong Powerhouse Sky and Weather Enhancement Pack. We're now passing through Leighton Buzzard. And we can now accelerate back up to 100 miles an hour. Just gonna have to shut the power off as we go through this neutral section. There we go. The 350 EP does come with neutral section functionality. Don't need to worry about that AWS warning, as that's for another crossover, which isn't applicable to us. This is the passenger view of the Desiro. As you can see, unfortunately, Armstrong Powerhouse neglected to retexture the seats in the passenger view, so hence why we've got the Southwest Trains maquette in instead of the London Midland maquette. They retextured it on the exterior model, but they didn't retexture it on the passenger view. I've also not gone out of my way to swap out the AI Class 350s for the Armstrong Powerhouse equivalent, just purely because I find that the 350s that come with this route are easier on frames than the Portsmouth Direct 450, which is what this EP is based off. Just passing through Cheddington. Just need to slow down to 90 miles per hour. Now passing Tring. And we can accelerate back up to 100. And we've got about 3 miles to go to Berkhamsted. Now going to slow down to 90 miles per hour once again. And we're now going to get ready to slow down for Berkhamsted. And here we are at Berkhamsted. After Berkhamsted, we've got to stop at Hemel Hempstead. Then we are running non-stop to Watford Junction and again to Euston. So the journey's gone pretty smoothly so far. That's the entrance building into the station. Looks alright. Another entrance building on the other side. It's a bit more substantial. Like the glass canopy there. So we've now got 3 miles to go to Hemel Hempstead. And the speed limit is about to increase to 100 miles per hour. Now going to get ready to slow down for Hemel Hempstead. So put brakes hard on, about halfway. Just going to increase the braking. Brakes are actually quite good on the 350EP. We're also quite good on the 350, which comes with this route. which I have had a little bit of a play with. Here we are at Hemel Hempstead. That's the entrance building. There we go. What's interesting about the 350 is that it won't let you change gear unless the train braking is at about 80-odd%, like that. So our next station stop is at Watford Junction, which is about 7 miles away. And before then we will be running non-stop through Apsley and Kings Langley. Just to go back to the default class 350 on this route, it's not a bad drive. It's just the sounds are not great on it. You get external run sounds in the passenger view, and also the brake squeal is horrible, and all the in-cab alarms are just too loud. So this is Apsley, and the speed limit has just dropped to 90 miles per hour. From here to Euston, the speed limit will fluctuate quite a bit. So I have to put the brakes hard on now for 75. So enjoying the scenery a bit too much there. There we go. Just slowed down just in time. Now passing through Kings Langley. and I think we've just passed beneath the M25. Although the speed limit has just gone up to 90, I'm actually going to start thinking about dropping down to 70, which is just coming up after this signal. Now I'm going to aim to accelerate up to 75 miles per hour. It's not much point in going up to 90. Perhaps we can, think we can get away with going a bit faster. I want to start slowing down about now. These speed changes do seem rather silly. Might as well just keep it at 75. Now I'm going to get ready to slow down for Watford Junction. There we go, so here we are at Wolverton Junction. Just waiting for the 350 that just passed us to come to a complete stop, so we don't have to damage our ears with the brake squeal. I think it's safe to go out now. We'll say the ambient sounds are a bit on the bit slightly louder. I think it could have been done with a bit of toning down. So we've now got 17 miles to go to Euston. Speed limit has now jumped up to 90. After the next signal, it's going to drop down to 80 before quickly jumping back up to 90. So I'm going to be aiming for 80. Shut the power off. Just passing through Bushy. And we can now accelerate up to 90 once again. Just passed a rather loud class 378. Speed limit is now 100. Just had to slow down to 90 again. We're now passing through Harrow and Wealdstone. It's worth noting that Armstrong Powerhouse have recently updated the Class 350 enhancement pack with some pantograph arcing and also a functional GSMR. I haven't shown those features off in this particular video because I'm yet to download that update. So Armstrong Powerhouse have actually pushed through quite a few updates over the past few months. shut the power off for the neutral section. Going to slow down to 75 miles per hour. Now passing through Wembley Central. Accelerate back up to 90, but we will have to slow down to 75 in a few moments time. Just had to slow down to 75 now. Have to get onto network rail about that tree we just passed. Just clip through the cab. We're now passing through Queen's Park Station. We're now passing under Primrose Hill Tunnel. This is the original bore, which was built at double its estimate price. Just need to slow right down to 40 miles per hour. And we've just got to be careful as we exit the tunnel as well, because there is a sharp dip in gradient as we pass beneath the fast lines. Now joined by the DC lines. The speed limit is raised to 50 miles per hour, though it is due to drop down to 40. And we are now on a sharp downwards gradient all the way into Euston. It's about 1 in 77, or 1 in 70. So we'll drop down to 40 miles per hour now. So this is by far the most challenging gradient. Just got to constantly watch the train speed and keep an eye on the signals at the same time. I do have a clear route into platform 5, so we just now need to slow right down to 25 miles per hour. And again to 15. And gradient is now flattened. And here we are at Euston. So I'll just wait for this instruction to finish. It's quite a good run that. Okay, that was a nice one. The lines were busy as usual, but you've managed very well. This is it for today. Have a well-deserved rest. So yeah, that was a very good scenario, and we only got caught with that minor speeding infringement that we picked up very early on. But other than that, that was very enjoyable, and that was probably really helped by the fact that we had the Armstrong Powerhouse Enhanced Class 350. So once again, you will need the Class 450 Desiro from the Portsmouth Direct Line, Waterloo to Portsmouth route, installed in order for that enhancement pack to work as intended. So I will leave a link to all of the relevant DLC in the description below, where you can pick them up if you haven't already done so. So thank you very much for watching this video. Hope you've enjoyed it, and take care.